Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 16, leçon W. And in this lesson, I received a request from someone asking me if it would be possible to make a video regarding l'imparfait du subjonctif. And here it is. So let's start now. You get to keep in mind when we talk about l'imparfait du subjonctif, actually three things. The first one will be utilisation rare. So it means that it is really rare to see l'imparfait du subjonctif. The second thing, un temps qui disparaît petit à petit. So little by little, it is less and less used. Okay. And the last thing, that utilisation exclusivement à l'écrit. Of course, it is quite tricky to say always, but then in most of the cases, you will see this imparfait du subjonctif written. Quite few persons are using this imparfait du subjonctif orally, okay? But then, well, it's possible, everything is possible, so, but then in most of the cases, it will be written, okay? So, it is rare, it tends to disappear, and it's mostly written, okay? And the other thing that you should keep in mind is that if we're talking about the verb être, to be, and avoir, to have, then in these cases you can see all the persons, okay? But in most of the cases for the other verbs, people will use only the third form. So whether the singular or the plural form, but then the third form, okay? So now let's imagine that we've got a sentence, okay? And in this sentence we've got la principale and we've got une subordonnée. Okay, so if we have l'imparfait de l'indicatif dans la principale, so in the first part, then normally we should put in the subordonnée l'imparfait du subjonctif, or then le plus que parfait du subjonctif. Okay, so that's the way it should be normally done. Okay, so imparfait de l'indicatif, imparfait du subjonctif. Let's give an example now. Il fallait qu'il parlât. Okay, so you can see that in this first part here, you've got il fallait, so it's imparfait de l'indicatif, and then normally you should put in this subordonnée qu'il parlât, and in that case you've got l'imparfait du subjonctif. Okay? But then, as we saw previously, it's also possible to have in the principal l'imparfait de l'indicatif and in the subordonné le plus que parfait du subjonctif, and we will get il fallait qu'il eût parlé. Okay, so exactly the same thing here. We've got imparfait de l'indicatif and in the subordonné we've got qu'il eût parlé, and this form here is actually what we call plus que parfait du subjonctif. Okay? Let's take now another situation in which we've got, so same thing, a sentence. So we've got la principale and then we've got la subordonnée. Okay? If we have le présent du conditionnel dans la principale, then normally we should have le présent du subjonctif dans la subordonnée, or then l'imparfait du subjonctif dans la subordonnée. But let's say that in most of the cases, this form won't be used, okay? Even if it would be possible and it would be correct, but then in most of the cases, people will skip that and they will stay with présent du conditionnel and then présent du subjonctif. So, let's have it here right now. Présent du conditionnel in the first part, dans la principale, il faudrait. And then you will have qu'il parle. Okay, so you can see that here it's the subjonctif présent. If you would like to have this il faudrait qu'il parle, so as I said, it should be or it could be correct, but then let's say that in most of the cases you won't see that anymore, okay? Because people tend to use the previous example that I gave you, in which you've got in the principal le présent du conditionnel and in the subordonné le présent du subjonctif. So, remember, as we saw, utilisation de toutes les personnes pour être ou avoir, and then for the other verbs, then we will only use this third person from the singular or the plural. Okay? So let's see now. Il désirait que vous parlassiez encore. So basically, it's correct. It's il désirait que vous parlassiez encore. But then we don't use that. Okay? It's too heavy now. So the question is, should we use il désirait que vous parliez encore? And well, clearly, it's not an option because it is not correct. So the only way that we would have a correct sentence would be to modify it and get il désirait vous entendre parler encore. Okay, and it's quite interesting here because if you look, well, the first one was correct, okay, but then it's not used anymore. I mean, this imparfait du subjonctif here for vous, as you saw, it's quite heavy and it's not used, okay. The second one in here, it's not possible because it's not correct, okay. And then this is the reason why we tend to use a structure. And if you look, this structure is quite interesting because actually, we won't use this subjunctive form. Okay, so there are some ways to avoid using le subjonctif, and one of the reasons is that in this video, in this situation, it's because l'imparfait du subjonctif is not used anymore, and so we try to find some ways to avoid using this imparfait du subjonctif. So, il désirait vous entendre parler encore. So, souvent possible d'éviter l'utilisation de l'imparfait du subjonctif. So, as I said, it's often possible to avoid using this form of this imparfait du subjonctif, okay? And the last thing, and one more time, as we saw, if you want to use this imparfait du subjonctif, well, keep in mind that it will be for the third person, just because the other forms are really impossible to produce. Not impossible, but quite heavy, and people don't like to use this form anymore, okay? I'm not talking, of course, as I said previously, about avoir and être, because they've got a special status, okay? And that's it. I hope it was clear and helpful. Have a great day. Bye-bye. Au revoir.